Did you ever wish for a tool that could keep track of all those complex commands from every hacking tool you use? You think of what you need to do, and boom, the tool translates your thoughts into neat, organized code, saving you time and hassle. It sounds like a dream, right? But it's not. I'll walk you through how to set this tool up, which is called Shell GPT. Basically, Shell GPT acts as a bridge between your terminal and ChatGPT, so you can chat with the AI right from your command line. Before we begin, I just want to give a huge shout out to my first ever YouTube member, Julian Kuhn. Thank you so much for your support. If you want to support me and get early access to videos, custom emojis, and a shout out at the end of every video, click the join button or click on the first link in the description. Thank you and let's get started. Step 1. Installing Python tools. For Mac users, use these commands. For Linux users, use these commands. We'll set up Shell GPT in a Python virtual environment to keep things clean and tidy. This ensures that Shell GPT won't mess with any other Python stuff you've got going on. Safety first, right? To get that set up, you'll need to install the Python virtual environment packages. For Mac users, use Python 3 m pip install virtual env, but for Linux users, use this command, sudo apt install Python 3 vanv. Step 2. Setting up a Python virtual environment. Now let's create a cozy little space for Shell GPT to live in. We'll make a directory to keep things organized. We're calling ours Shell GPT, but you can name it whatever you like. Once it's made, hop into that directory. We're going to set up a special environment just for Shell GPT using Python's virtual environment magic. We'll call it Shell GPT because, well, why not? Now we've got a private little haven for Shell GPT inside our Shell GPT directory. But hold up, we're not done yet. We need to activate this virtual environment so that Shell GPT can do its thing. To do that, we'll run a script called activate, found in the bin directory of our virtual environment. Time to bring Shell GPT to life. Step 3. Getting your ChatGPT API key. Head over to the OpenAI website. If you already have an account, great. Just log in. If not, go ahead and sign up. Once you're logged in, click on your account name in the top right corner. A menu will pop up. Select View API Keys from the menu. This will take you to the API Keys page. On the API Keys page, you'll see a button that says Create New Secret Key. Click on that. Now give your new key a name. It can be anything you want, just something to help you remember what it's for. Once you've named it, hit the green Create Secret Key button. Voila, your shiny new API key will be displayed to you. This is the only time you'll see it in its entirety, so make sure to copy it. Paste your API key into a text editor and save it with a name that makes sense to you. This key is your ticket to accessing ChatGPT's powers, so keep it safe. And there you have it, your very own ChatGPT API key, ready to unleash the magic. Now that you've got your hands on that shiny new API key, let's make sure Shell GPT can use it. If you're up for a quick command line trick, just type the following, replacing your secret API key with your actual API key. Step 5. Installing Shell GPT. Now that we've got everything set up, it's time to bring Shell GPT into the mix. Installing it is a breeze using the trusty Python pip command. Just let it do its thing, and when it's finished, you're all set to dive into the world of Shell GPT and ChatGPT. Step 6. Chat away. Let's take a look at few examples to understand this tool more clearly. Example 1. SGPT shell. How to see the firewall rules. This command will give you the exact code you'll need to see the firewall rules. Example 2. SGPT. How to see the firewall rules using firewalled command. This is a more specific request. It's asking how to view firewall rules, but specifically using a tool called Firewalled. Firewalled is a program that helps manage firewall settings in some Linux systems. So this question is about how to use firewalled commands to look at firewall rules. Example 3. SGPT code. Create a bash script to delete files in a given location older than 30 days. This will write the exact code in bash language to automatically remove files from a certain place on your computer that are more than 30 days old. You can find all the syntax of this tool in its GitHub page. I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you did, please make sure to like, subscribe, and see you in the next video.